To crack CAT, you need a lot of practice. And you can practice by taking CRACO's free mock. Just Google search CRACO free CAT mock. Follow the link to get the free mock. We have put in a free mock with the latest pattern and with detailed solutions. Hi friends, welcome to CRACO's video series. I'm Sayali Kale. I'm one of the co-founders of CRACO and an alumna of IIM Ahmedabad. In today's video, we are going to discuss whether it is a question that has been on the minds of many students who keep asking in like comment section or on our chat as such. They ask if it is now too late to start for CAT 2019. So since August has already arrived, CAT is around 3 months away. So many students wonder if it is too late to start. So here we'll try to answer that question and we'll try to give you a way forward as such. So let's begin by answering the question, when is the right time to start? See, generally we ask students to start about 6 to 7 months before CAT. However, the ideal time to start for student depends changes from student to student. It depends upon what your existing skill sets are. And secondly, how much time you can give. Now, if you are somebody who has already taken CAT once, then the amount of time required for you to actually catch up would be much lesser. You'd already know quite a few things about the exam as such. So then, in that case, you can easily cover the content that is there within 3 months easily. Even if you are new to CAT, if this is the first time you are taking the exam, still you can make up, provided you are able to give enough amount of time for preparing for the exam. When we tell students to start 6 months earlier, we ask them to start giving at least 1 hour a day. Now that you are starting 3 months before the exam, you have to give up to 3 hours a day. So you have to put in more time just to make up for the lost time as such. So is it too late to start? Definitely it is not too late to start. You can definitely catch up, provided you are able to stick to a schedule and consistently give 3 hours a day. For those who are working and who can't give time on the weekdays, if you're able to take out a good chunk of time on the weekends, even then it can work. For example, if you're a working professional, what I would suggest is give at least half an hour to an hour during the weekdays. And on the weekends, you can take the longer tests, so like the mock tests, etc., which take more amount of time. So if you can put 6 hours on the weekends, on each of the weekend days, and just an hour during the weekdays, even then that would work. But essentially, because you are starting 3 months before CAT, you have to give more time and you have to stick to a schedule. If you do not stick to a schedule, then your studying will not be effective. Now you have to be very time effective because there is little time left till CAT. So you have to have a good strategy in place, a good schedule in place. Only then would you cover all the things that you have to read, plus get the adequate amount of practice. Just remember that most of your peers also are going to start around the same time. So even if you think that maybe there are many students who have started much earlier than me, it's no point for me to start now. Ultimately, you have to get somewhere about 99.6 plus. So even if a 99.99 percentiler has started months before you, that's still fine. You can still do well in CAT given 3 months as such, provided you have consistent study patterns, and secondly, you have a schedule in place. In addition to this, you have to make sure that you customize this according to your own needs and preferences. So depending on what your strengths are and what your weaknesses are, you study according to that. I think 3 months is more than enough to actually cover all the things that you need to learn and crack CAT. See, ultimately the content is not really new to you. The content is essentially what you have studied till 10th standard. So none of the formulas are new, none of the ideas are new as such. You just need to revise them. And the focus should be on practice. That is where the key difference lies between somebody who is scoring 80 percentile versus somebody who is scoring 95 percentile above. The person who is scoring 95 percentile above definitely has a lot more practice than the person who is scoring 80 percentile. So make sure that you put in the adequate amount of effort to cover all the concepts, plus put in dedicated efforts to practice every day. If you do that, then 3 months is more than enough to actually complete everything. Now let's consider what is needed to actually crack CAT. So firstly, as I said, you need a schedule. So by schedule, I mean two things. Basically, a day-to-day list of activities that you have to do. So this should include what concepts you have to cover, what you have to practice, what mocks you have to take as well as to analyze. So if you are able to say, okay, on this day I'm going to cover this concept, on this day I'm going to practice from this topic, on this day I'm going to take this mock, or on this day I'm just going to sit and analyze how I did in the mock. If you cover these three parts sufficiently, then you are going to have a good amount of coverage as far as CAT is concerned. Remember, you don't have to cover every single formula in CAT. The focus should not be on just making sure you know all the concepts. Knowing all the concepts does not necessarily translate into doing well in CAT exam. This is a very practice-oriented exam. Just mugging all the concepts is not going to work. Which means that you have to have a schedule which not only incorporates concepts, but also has tests related to those concepts. Tests which are topic tests based on areas of strength and weaknesses, and proper full-length mock tests so that you have a good idea on a holistic level how you're doing as in each section. So it's not only the topics that you like, but even in the topics that you don't like, how exactly are you doing? And you need to put in time not just to take the mock, but to analyze the mock. Where am I going right? Where am I going wrong? What is the areas that I could improve in so that my percentile takes the next jump as such? So this is what your schedule should include. It should be essentially a day-to-day list of, okay, on this day I have to do this, on this day I have to do this, and this day I have to do this. The second part that your schedule should actually include, and many people skip this, is when you are going to do this. So it should have a dedicated time slot when you are going to study. If you are a student, then you have a fairly mostly fixed schedule as such. You would have your lectures during the day. After that, you might have studies related to your undergrad, and then you will have like at least an hour or an hour and a half of time for dedicating to CAT. So you should identify when I'm going to sit and study. If it's in the evening, then identify that this is a slot from 6 to 9 p.m. before dinner, I'm going to sit and study. If you're working professional and you have lesser flexibility, even then make at least an hour slot which you are definitely going to hit every single day. If you are somebody who works till late in the evening, make sure that you start studying early in the morning before you go to work, or study late at night. But you have to consistently put in 1 hour every single day, otherwise you're not going to hit your target as such. So you have to identify what you're going to do for every single day from now till CAT, and you have to identify when you're going to do it during your day. If you have a hard and fast time slot for every single day, then will you actually study. A lot of people end up drawing schedules that they never stick to. That is because they fail in the second aspect of committing to a time slot. If you don't commit to a time slot, then you'll find yourself putting work off till later and later in the day, till there comes a time when you don't do things at all. So make sure that you have a strict starting time of when you're going to start studying. Then the second thing that you're going to need is a good understanding of concepts. See, you're going solving questions, and just solving questions without understanding the underlying concepts is not going to help much, because you're going to keep making the same errors again and again. There will be the same areas where you're not good at, the same areas where you tend to lose marks or have poor accuracy. So you have to study all the concepts. Given that, basically you should have a strategic outlook to what concepts you should study. This isn't like other exams where you have to list down 5 reasons or something like that, where you have to mug everything and hope that one of the questions comes from the topic. This is not that. Here you need to know formulas, you need to know concepts, and much more importantly, you need to know when to apply them and where to apply them. And that understanding and knowledge will only come through practice. So any concept learning without practice is completely useless. So make sure that whenever you take a concept, whenever you learn a concept, you take a concept test. Otherwise, you have just wasted your time. So you have to have a good understanding of concepts. You have to have in your schedule, you should say, okay, I'm going to do arithmetic concepts this day. I'm going to do geometry. I'm going to do triangles or circles or this particular concepts in this day. And it's important to know that, okay, if this is the thing that I'm covering, I need to solve some questions based on it. If I don't solve questions based on it, I'm just going to end up forgetting what I've done. So you need a good understanding of concepts. Remember that just remembering or mugging up formula is not going to help you. Even if you mug up the formula, it is not going to come to you in the actual CAT exam, because most of the CAT questions are not framed in such a way that it is a direct application of formula. So knowing the formula is not going to help unless you put in the link via practicing. And the third, as I said, practice, practice, practice. And practice should include the following things, okay? You need to have, firstly, a concept level practice. Secondly, you should need topic level practice. So concept level practice is basically the minute you do a concept, you have to take the concept test for that practice, for that particular concept. Second is topic level practice. So what I notice is that students consistently keep doing weak in certain topics. They are not comfortable in some certain topics. For example, some of the topics that most of the students are very weak in are like geometry. Many students are very weak in that. Some students are very weak in, say, PNC. Some students are very weak in number systems. So depending on the topic that you are weak in, make sure that you put in time, put aside time to like practice questions from that topic. I cannot emphasize enough how important addressing these weaknesses through practice is. Knowing the concept most of the times will not help you improve. What will help you improve is actually solving questions based on it. So a lot of my students I know just end up watching videos but don't take the concept test afterwards. That is not going to help you as much. Knowing the concept is just one part of the journey. The second part or the bigger part is essentially solving the questions that come after the concept test. So make sure that you take the concept test every single time, and after completing a week, you whenever you have completed, say, a week where triangles has been discussed, please make sure that you go to the study room and start practicing questions from triangles. If you don't do that, then it is completely wasted. The last thing that you need is mocks. Now, since you have 3 months left, you have to be realistic about how many mocks you can take and analyze well. So I'd say that aim to take 10 mocks, but make sure that you completely analyze them. So you should know exactly which sections you're poor in. From each mock, you should have feedback. Okay, I need to work on this section. I need to work on this section. I need to work on this section. I need to work in these areas. Taking mocks for the sake of it and then not analyzing it will not help you. So make sure that you take 10 mocks. 10 mocks is the, at least you should take 10 mocks, but you should analyze them thoroughly. There should be no question which you got wrong in any of these mocks that you didn't take a second look at. So you should go through that mock again afterwards to make sure that you know how to solve each of the questions that you got wrong. If you put in this kind of practice, then I'm pretty sure that you are going to be able to make it an actual CAT. So make sure that you have these three things down: your schedule, understanding of concepts, and practice. So all of these three together are going to help you crack CAT. Now let's go on to the last part of where to start. So firstly, firm up your schedule. So as I said, make sure that you write down the list of activities that you are going to do. Basically, I put activities because essentially it can be either concept learning or practice or mock test. Depends upon what you have to achieve on that particular day. So just write down your schedule. Now, if you don't know where to start or what is important, Kraku has a 3 months plan or 3 months course that is coming up. You can follow the schedule. If you are part of the course, then you get everything part of the course. You get the concept videos, you get the concept tests, you get mocks. So you get everything given in one course and in one place as such. Even if you're not part of the course, you can still follow the schedule, because that schedule is a sensible schedule that you can use given the limited time you have. Because you have just 3 months left, you have to prioritize which topics you have to do first. So it is a schedule which first prioritizes the big things. It prioritizes arithmetic, it prioritizes geometry, it prioritizes reading comprehension. So it's a sensible schedule you can follow for 3 months. Even if you don't have, even if you don't subscribe to the course, you can just go to Kraku's website and search for the Krakow's 3-month course, you'll get a day-to-day schedule that you can follow. Just follow that schedule saying that, okay, I have to learn this concept. I'll search online, I'll try to see what are the formulas involved in it. If you don't want to put in all this extra effort, you can just subscribe to the course so that you get everything that you need in one place and it's more time efficient for you. So firstly, make up your schedule. Your schedule is very, very important for you to crack at. If you don't have that, you are starting off at a disadvantage. Secondly, and I say this to a lot of students, that you should set up your study space. This is essentially something I learned. See, whenever you have a very big exam, like a 10th standard or 12th standard exam, you tend to take it seriously because there is a peer group around you which is also working hard, which is keeping you involved in the day-to-day activities. CAT is not that exam because quite often you won't have that peer group. If you're working, for example, it's difficult to keep focused on two activities as such. So it's very important that you have a space that you can go to where you get into the zone immediately. So essentially, when I say study space, your study space should be such that your schedule should be in front of you, printed out, and you should be able to tick things off it. Secondly, you should have a sheet showing your mock scores. So essentially, if you're going to take 10 mocks or 15 mocks, print out all the mocks that you're going to take. Then put your one column, make a table essentially, make one column for your overall percentile, make one column for your quant percentile, one column for your verbal percentile and DILR percentile. So every time you take the mock, write down there how much you have scored. So this is like a visual reminder of how you're doing. So it's easy to ignore signals such as you're falling behind or falling behind in certain sections. If this is there in front of your eyes, it's a daily reminder that you have to work on things. So make sure that you set up your study space such that these things are directly in front of you all the time. The third thing that you have to do is you have to basically identify a good source of learning. So identify where you're going to study from. You can either choose to go with Krakow. You get all the concepts, you get all the practice tests that you need. You get 10,000 questions. If you're not studying through Krakow, what you need is basically you study from. Basically, you need essentially some place where your concepts are cleared and you get at least 2,000 to 3,000 questions to practice. Don't study from books. Static books, because they tend to be firstly outdated and secondly they are not friendly in terms of solving. So you need to get practice of solving by looking at a computer screen. That's how the actual CAT is going to be administered. So make sure that you make that switch early on. The more you practice of a computer aided system, the better it is, because then you're going to get acclimatized to taking the actual CAT. So make sure that you solve about 2,000 to 3,000 questions in terms of practice. So these questions should be from your area of strengths and weaknesses. Wherever you are weak, you should be practicing. Wherever you are strong and you know for sure that you are going to be tackling questions from that particular topic, you have to practice even those areas. So make sure that you identify a source now that I'm going to practice from here. I'm going to practice every single day. I'm going to solve these many questions and I'm going to read all my concepts from here. And this should match up with your schedule. So you should know before you sit down for studying where you are going to study from. Now the last thing that you need to do for starting is basically prioritize. This is something I see a lot of students make a mistake in. It's easy to make a mistake here because essentially students end up giving a lot of priority to things that either they feel afraid of or they are good at. So a lot of students who are good at quant feel that they like to solve questions from number systems, especially difficult questions from number systems. But those questions are rarely asked. Questions that come from number systems are the easier questions, which are based on divisibility or that are based on HCF and LCM. But the harder questions from number systems rarely come in CAT these days. So you have to prioritize. What should I study first? So the first topics that you should study always are arithmetic, geometry, and reading comprehension. Along with this, you need to start with solving DILR sets. Start off with easier DILR sets. and go on to moderate DIL assets and go on to harder DIL assets. So essentially, DILR is essentially a question of confidence. If you know that given a DIL asset, I know exactly how to represent the information. If you know exactly how to solve one DIL asset, you get the confidence of solving the next DIL asset. So you have to get into this mode where you not only solve a lot of DIL assets, but you also try to understand how did I come to the solution. So you should know, okay, that to solve this DIL asset, I needed to represent this information in this particular way. Once you start making that link, once you start identifying what are the right ways of representing information in DIL assets, then it becomes easier for you to solve even the new types of DIL assets. So if you focus on these four things from the very start and make sure that your schedule also reflects this, then you're going to have a good chance of covering everything that is important as far as CAT is concerned. See, essentially, you need not solve every single question in CAT. This is not a paper like 12th standard where you have to get 97% or 98%. This is a paper you have to get like 70% of the questions you have to attempt in quant. If you can do that, you will reach 95% easily. So make sure that you are not going crazy over portion coverage. It's important to cover different concepts, but it's more important to have adequate practice of every single concept that you have learned. So make sure that whenever you learn a concept, you practice and prioritize these four topics and prioritize their practice over the practice of everything else. So if it's like I don't know this particular small concept of PNC, or I have not practiced enough questions from profit and loss, you should choose practicing questions from profit and loss over learning a tiny small concept from PNC. Bayes theorem rarely comes in actual CAT, but questions from profit and loss come every single year. So if you have to prioritize, you should know which side you have to pick. So make sure that you don't spend too much time on things that are not important while spending enough time on things that are actually important. Arithmetic is super important for CAT. Geometry is super important for CAT. Reading comprehension is the heart and soul of verbal. DIL assets you can only solve through practice. There is nothing, no other way that you can actually solve DILR. So make sure that you make these things a priority. So this is all I have to say as far as cracking CAT is concerned. If you are worried about how you can get the schedule in place, please go over to Krakow's website. We have a 3-month plan which is there for everybody who is facing a time crunch as far as their CAT is concerned. You will get a day-to-day schedule. You will get concept videos to look at. You will get concept tests to solve based on those concept videos. You will get access to 25 mocks. You will get access to the study room so that you can practice questions from the study room. So you can get you get topic tests as well. So you have essentially everything you need, that you everything that you can possibly want for cracking CAT in 3 months, you have in one place. So you can head over and take a look at that. Thank you for tuning in.